Hey, Victory, I thought I'd reach out to you via video just to kind of update you on a couple of things. Thought it might be a lot easier than you reading a long email. But I hope your new year is off to a good start. And this next Sunday, I'm going to be preaching in both of our services the State of the Church Address. And we're going to review 2020 and a lot of the blessings and challenges that the Lord saw us through. And we'll talk more about that. One of the things I want to do for us, though, as COVID continues on, I guess we've been affected by it now for nearly a year, is we want to try to do the best we can to make it possible for everyone to attend, really to remove any hindrances that may keep any of us from coming, because there are several of our congregation that haven't been here in the last few months just out of concern for the COVID. We totally understand that. So beginning this Sunday, January 10th, we're going to go back to our normal schedule. There's just going to be one slight adjustment just to try to make it more possible for all of us to be together. And that is our 9 o'clock service will be normal service, mask recommended. And our kids will have Pistol Creek Kids Church during that hour, and adults will stay in the sanctuary. Then the middle hour, or the second hour, we're going to go back to our life group. So you check in with your life group leader and be a part of that again. Then the 11:30 hour, I've decided to make that mask required. And the reason that I want to do that is I want to give an opportunity for anybody who would come to church if it was mask required, just out of safety, concern for their own safety, a chance to be here. I want to make sure that I'm not creating any obstacle to keep you out of church. You know, the Bible says that we're not to forsake the assembling of ourselves together, and especially as we see the day approaching. I believe the Holy Spirit saw into the future of our time right now, and the encouragement was not just to assemble together, but especially as you see the day approaching. So apparently the Holy Spirit knew, of course we know he did, that in the last days there will be hindrances even to getting together. And I think a pandemic is a legitimate hindrance. So we just want to offer you as safe as we can environment in the 11:30 service. And hopefully some of you that haven't been able to come will be able to attend that 11:30 service. And if you're in Pinnacle Life Group, we're going to make that mask mandatory too, if you don't mind. You know, it's been so tough over the last year with people on so many different sides of this issue that, as a pastor, I've, of course, realized over the last three decades, nearly four decades I've been doing this, that you can't please everybody for sure. You know, if you walk down the middle, then one side, both sides don't like you. But I feel like it's right for me to lead that way. And so that 11:30 service will be mask required. And if you don't prefer to wear a mask, then you'll want to come to the 9 o'clock service. But hopefully what that'll do is that'll give you guys the ability who are super concerned, and rightfully so, about the coronavirus because of your family situation or your own health situation, you will have the opportunity to come into a safe environment at 11:30 on Sundays. All right, guys, I love you. I can't wait to see you. I hope you'll be here Sunday, each and every one of you. And as I give us our annual State of the Church Address, got some great news to report. And I'm also going to start the clock ticking on a project that I want the church to weigh in on. So please be there, at least be online, but we'd really love to see you in person. Love you bunches, guys. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.